Following recent housing protests, which brought Plettenberg Bay to a near standstill, Bitou communities had the opportunity to voice their concerns to various high-ranking politicians.
We all know about the portion 20 land that has been purchased already 2 years ago. Our question, or my question, is seeing that we have a lot of backyard dwellers living in your license already, that has been living, that some of them are 40 years old, some of them 50 years old, living in sheds in the backyards of their parents' yards, when will you guys start developing portion 20? We don't want you to purchase the other land and wait for that. We want you to develop portion 20 of the visa so that our community, the 450 top structure that you want there, so that people can start moving out of the backyards and into their houses.
And I think that the criteria must be reviewed so that when people get houses, the minister and the community also know that the people that get houses are the deserving people that get those houses.
Politicians also responded to various questions from the community.
We must be able to also create jobs out of that piece of land. It's a huge piece of land. You must be able to create jobs. I mean, if this hall can be full at this time of the day, it tells me that the majority of people in this community are unemployed.
Now, there's this assumption which I need to correct right here and right now, that housing must be prioritized for people who are living in sheds only. That is a very wrong assumption.
Yes.
Housing is prioritized for people who meet the criteria that I've just outlined.
Yes.
And also who meet the principle of first come, first serve, as I said.
Yes.
So if you've registered 20 years ago, it can't be that you are still waiting and yet a person who registered 2 years ago is already living in an RTP house or VHO.
Some residents were, however, not satisfied with the response from the politicians and proceeded to walk out of the meeting.